Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. The Lent is over. We fasted 47 days, and today is the last day. And every day we prayed liturgies, we fasted, and we asked us to accept our repentance. So today is the end. If you attended the prophecies in the morning, it starts with the end of the life of Jacob and Joseph and Job. And this shows us that no matter how long we live on earth, we will come to an end. The smart person doesn't wait for the end, but listens to what Jesus said today. Jesus did it all, and even Isaiah the prophet said it. What can I do for my vineyard I didn't do? I did it all. He created me. He saved me, died for me. He prepared for me mansion in his kingdom. And he's telling me, come and follow me. That's why today is the day of the decision. Either you will be under his curse to Jerusalem when he said, I wanted to gather your kids, but you refused. Your house will be desolate. Or you are one of the people who will say glory to God in the heaven. You are welcoming God to come. This will position you for the Palm Sunday. In Palm Sunday, we had three types of people. We had people saying Hosanna from their heart, and people saying Hosanna from their mouths. When they came to Pilate's court, they said, crucify him. And we had people, they rejected both groups. They don't want anybody to say Hosanna to this man. So what is your heart saying to God today? I want to ask you this question. Are you saying, God, I am for you, I choose to be with you, and I'm saying Hosanna? Or you are hesitant, the hesitant group. When I'm in church, I'm a good person. When I'm outside church, I'm a bad person. If I apply the three groups I talked about for Palm Sunday to our life, the first group, which is saying Hosanna from their heart, are the faithful people who comes to God with their heart, with their hearts, seeking him and following him. And those are the saints like you. And the other group are a group of people, they come to church, they act very well in the church, but when they leave the church, they have totally opposite life. They hate, they curse, they steal, they do every bad stuff. And their life doesn't glorify God. And the third one are the people who are not with us today, not because of their work, because they don't want to come to church, because they feel this is a waste of time. My beloveds, Jesus said that today is final. You will not see me again till you say glory to God in the highest. When we say glory to God in the highest, anybody can help me? How many times we say glory to God in the highest? امتى بنقول المجد لله في الأعالي? Yes. At the end of the liturgy, when the priest will present the body and blood of Jesus Christ to the congregation, they will say glory to God in the highest. When other than this? It's Zuxeba 3. When we, in the procession of the Lamb, we say it again. Every time, I don't want to take you into this exercise, but I want to take something from this. That every time Jesus present in our midst, we say, glory to God in the highest. So the good, faithful Christian will feel the presence of God always in his heart. Till the final day, when Jesus comes in the clouds with his angels, what you're going to say? There are two sayings. There is nothing more than two sayings. The unfaithful, they will say to the mountains, cover us. They know this is a time of condemnation. The other faithful people like you will say, glory to God in the highest. My beloveds, it's still, we have a chance. If you are not in a good terms with anybody, reconcile with him for the sake of God. If you are not praying, pray. if you are not focusing in the church and playing with your phone, turn your phone off and put it in your pocket. Be with God. You cannot say glory to God and you are not with him. You cannot say it. You may say it from your mouth, but you cannot say it from your heart. Because when you say it from your heart, you feel his presence. And this is the final word I want to put in your heart. I want you to feel the continuous presence with God. This is will be great. Why? Why I'm telling you this? Because this is will prevent you from sinning. This is will make you glorify God. This is will protect you from the world. And this is will be the taste of eternity. Are you familiar with this expression, taste of eternity? Don't think you will be with God when you depart the body. If you are not with God now, you cannot enjoy him later. Taste of eternity. This is a word I want to keep in your ears. Take it to your heart. What is the taste of eternity? Continuous presence with God. Continuous presence with God. Imagine if I put it into your life. You can say a bad word if you feel in the presence of God. Huh? The Abuna, we respect him. What about God? We cannot, right? You can have a bad look when you feel in the presence of God. So the exercise today is, I feel I am with God. I feel the continuous presence with God. Because this will let my heart always say glory to God in the highest, and glory be to God forever. Amen.